Yep. The grand Ethereum Elrond Bridge is finally here. And we've got you covered, as always, on how to use it. We will first talk about what a bridge is, and then get straight into the how-to and show you step-by-step how to bridge your Ethereum tokens to Elrond. In the beginning, only tokens that are whitelisted by Elrond can be bridged over from Ethereum. If you already know what a bridge is, feel free to skip forward to the how-to section. We left timestamps for you below. There are many blockchains out there today which come with the native coin, like eGLD is for Elrond, BTC for Bitcoin, ETH for Ethereum, etc. Those who support smart contracts also support the creation of tokens on their blockchain, tokens which closely inherit the capabilities and therefore also limitations of the native coin. It would be great though if tokens were not isolated to the chain they were created on. It would be great if they could travel between different networks, so owners of these tokens and the projects themselves could explore other DeFi opportunities on other blockchains. And of course, so they could take advantage of chains that are faster, more scalable, with cheaper fees, and more stable. This is called interoperability, and this is why bridges exist. A bridge between two blockchains allows you to do just that, transfer or bridge over a token from one blockchain to another. So let the floodgates open, because Ethereum projects and users can finally discover Elrond and experience the difference. Let's move on, and we'll show you how to transfer a token from Ethereum to Elrond. Using the bridge is way simpler than you think. First of all, we will access bridge.elrond.com. I will be using the test bridge, as the official bridge is not yet live at the recording of this video. We will leave the from and to fields as they are, since we do want to transfer from Ethereum to Elrond. Here, initially, we can select from a list of Elrond-approved tokens to transfer between the two networks. This list will of course get updated and more tokens will be added down the line. Let's imagine we have some Ethereum USDC tokens that we want to bridge over to the Elrond network. We will select the asset that we wish to bridge to Elrond from the list, and then enter the amount of tokens to transfer. In our case, we will choose USDC, and we will send over 2,500 USDC. Below, you can see the transfer details, such as if there will be any fee from Elrond's bridge associated with it. Now, we will need to connect our MetaMask wallet. We'll click on Connect Source Wallet, select the account that holds the tokens you wish to transfer, and we will approve the connection in our MetaMask extension. Step 1 is done. In step 2, we will connect our Elrond wallet, the one where we wish to deposit our tokens in. If you don't have an Elrond wallet, please visit wallet.elrond.com and create one, or download the Myer app on your phone, the beautiful, non-custodial wallet from the Elrond team. And as you can see, there are a few Elrond wallet options to choose from. I will choose to connect with the Maya DeFi wallet, which is a browser extension just like MetaMask, created by the Elrond team. I will unlock it and select the wallet where I wish to receive my tokens. And we're almost done. Step 3 is where we will check one more time the details of our transfer. And if everything looks good, we will go ahead and confirm the transfer. You can choose to start over if something doesn't look right. I'll go ahead and click on Confirm Swap. We will be asked to confirm a few transactions in our MetaMask wallet. The fee here is from the Ethereum blockchain itself for the transactions. And sadly, Elrond has no control over that. We will confirm the first transaction and wait for the Ethereum network to process it. Now, there's only one more transaction to approve in the MetaMask. Let's go ahead and do that. Now that that's all done, we have to wait a minimum of 10 minutes for the transaction to be secured on Ethereum before it can finally be processed on Elrond. We don't have to do anything more but wait for this process to finish. And it's done. We click on the transaction hash to check out the transfer details on the Elrond Blockchain Explorer. Seems like we have a successful one. we can check our wallet to make sure we received the tokens and everything went smoothly. Thank you so much for watching. If you want to support us, consider liking this video, consider subscribing to our channel, and of course, consider staking with us. We would also love to hear from you. Drop us a comment below, tell us your thoughts, and tell us what subject you would like us to cover in our next videos. Until next time, Mountaineers.